Hello guys, today I'll be discussing another new drug approved by FDA in 2020, and that drug is called as Tazemetostat. And Tazemetostat, guys, it is a new drug which acts by blocking EZH2 methyl transferase. Now this EZH2 methyl transferase is upregulated in some cancers, and one of them is epitheloid cancer or epitheloid sarcoma. Guys, epitheloid sarcoma is a rare type of sarcoma, and it constitutes only 1% of the total soft tissue sarcoma, right? And in epitheloid sarcoma, where do I use this drug? I use this drug in case it is metastatic or locally advanced, which cannot be resected. The reason being, the management of epitheloid sarcoma, the management is surgical, guys. So surgical removal of the tumor is the mainstay of management, and that is coupled with radiotherapy along with anti-cancer drugs, which are used nowadays, are drugs like Doxorubicin and Ifosfamide. So these are the anti-cancer drugs which are used currently for treatment of epitheloid sarcoma, but they are not specific, you know, they are not cell cycle specific drugs. But this drug is specific Tazemetostat because there is an overexpression of EZH2 methyl transferase in these epitheloid sarcoma. So basically they cause epitheloid sarcoma. So we now have a very specific drug. That is how this drug is a win-win situation for all of us. Now let us see what could be the possible mechanism of action. See guys, in the diagram, see we have EZH2 complex of methyl transferase, and the active component of EZH2, or which has catalytic activity, is called a SET. And what is the function of SET? It donates methyl to S-adenosyl methionine and converts this to SAH or S-adenosyl homocysteine. Now what S-adenosyl homocysteine does, it down-regulates those genes which are responsible for apoptosis of cells. So if cells, they do not go undergo apoptosis, there will be increased clustering or proliferation of these cells, giving us cancer or tumor, right? Now what I have done is I've designed a drug called as Tazemetostat, which blocks this EZH2 methyl transferase or SET, because of which there is no conversion of S-adenosyl methionine to S-adenosyl homocysteine, and that removes that block on those genes, and that increases gene expression, which leads to cell apoptosis by various mechanisms and ultimately causes death of these cells, right? So this is a mechanism of action of Tazemetostat, guys. Now, if I talk about its route of administration, it is an oral drug which is given a dose of 800 milligrams twice a day. Side effect is not complicated, guys. Being an anti-cancer drug, most common side effect is nausea, vomiting. Apart from that, like many anti-cancer drugs like cyclophosphamide, I mean alkylating agents and platinum compounds, they do cause secondary leukemia. So guys, this is what we had to learn today. A new drug approved by FDA in 2020, Tazemetostat, guys. So I'll keep on posting these new drugs and a lot of new stuffs in my YouTube channel, guys. So do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on this particular button. All the best. Thank you.